bottom line is that there's a lot of unfairness that comes from this board. And like I said, I commend you for the decision that you made on this issue, but I commend you on the others that you took a position on. My personal opinion, and the opinion of others, I'm a member of the People's Tribune. And I feel that the head of this superintendent needs to resign. I feel that some of those board members that's on this board need to be voted out of position. And, you know, because of the past decisions that you've made, that in a city where 51% is black and 40% live below the poverty level and 43% earn less than $10,000 a year, and the students, their children, and when you spend money on building and on construction of construction schools and spending money, you don't seem to realize these factors are not the people of this community. And like I said, very dissatisfied with the economy. And hope you take it to heart that the superintendent needs to resign and the rest of you need to vote out of office. Thank you.
On behalf of the full Board of Education, add my welcome to each of you for joining us this evening. We appreciate big crowds, and we appreciate your interest in Valdosta City Schools. At this time, I think we might have a potential change in the agenda, or do we need an approval of the agenda at this time?
Need a motion to approve the agenda, Mr.
We have a motion to approve the agenda. Is that right, Mr. Lee? Okay. All right. Very good. We have a motion. Second. Call the question.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to move the miscellaneous
aid. Mr. Lee, you pick up your mic. Those people can't hear you.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to move miscellaneous aid. The agenda to executive session. So it would be B, small a. And the action will be taken out as you were, Mr. Chairman. The 21 miscellaneous agents consideration will also need to be a B, an A, a 1 on the pen of litigation.
OK. Okay, so let me just clarify for Ms. Jennings. I don't know if she got all that. Mr. Roundtree, can you turn this mic down a little bit, please? From what I understand, Mr. Lee, you're wanting to move 21A to 19BA. Is that what I understand? I want to make sure we get it correct, Ms. Jennings.
We need to add 19. Miscellaneous A needs to be as is, but it also needs to be discussed in executive session.
Okay. Yeah, we do have it under executive session at this time. Very good. So we have a motion and a second. Any other additional questions at this time? All in favor of approving the agenda as presented? Any opposed? Like sign. All right, motion carries. We have approved the agenda for tonight's meeting. I would entertain a approval for the minutes dated March 23rd, 2021. Motion. We have a motion and a second. All in favor of approval of the minutes? Motion carries unanimously, Ms. Jennings. I would ask you all to review the minutes dated April 13th and also April 21st, and we'll vote on those in the next meeting. Having said that, we'll move on to...
with the administration of the school. If the problem cannot be resolved at the school level, it shall then be brought to the superintendent or his designee. If the problem cannot be resolved at the superintendent of schools, it may then be brought to the Board of Education. Regulations for public participation, 30 minutes will be set aside at Board of Education meetings for public comment. This time limit may be increased at the board's discretion. Persons who wish to speak at a meeting must sign in prior to the meeting, state of name and topic of discussion. The following rules for addressing the Board of Education shall apply. Up to two persons may speak on each side of an issue. Each speaker shall be limited to 5 minutes. Personnel issues shall not be discussed in open meetings except as provided by federal, state, local law, and policy. References to an employee must be made using the terms teacher, administrator, or employee. Persons who refuse to follow accepted rules of conduct may be removed from the meeting. Persons speaking must address the Board of Education rather than the audience. And at this time we have, I think Pastor Floyd Rose, football coach, is the topic. We had someone sign in prior, but I think they scratched their names.
Y'all, forgive me. I am 82 years old, and I hope you can hear what I have to say. I've been attending board meetings for a long time. And on last Thursday, I got a call to appear before an attorney representing the wife of the former coach of Belmont High, and they mentioned that I had, they thought I had some reputation in the community, and so they wanted to oppose me, so I agreed to go. And I want to say to you what I said to them. I've been attending these board meetings for a long time, and when it was all white, there was no problem. Decisions were made to either keep somebody or let them go, and nothing was said about it. But when it became predominantly black, all hell things were broken loose. And I don't like that. I didn't like it then, I don't like it now, and I won't like it tomorrow. And I would hope that this board would do what it decided to do and hold on to what it said it was going to do, which was to, as I understand it, which was to maintain the position that it held a while back. I hope that's what you decide to do tonight. I think that's all I have. And you'll have to forgive me, but it's 8 o'clock and I go to bed, so I have to get up in the morning. God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor, for joining us tonight. Casey Carter, it looks like the next on the list.
Decision that you made on this issue, but on the other that you took a position on.
painting and painting a lot of, I'm a member of the people's building. And I feel that the head of the superintendent needs to resign. I feel that some of those board members, some of those board need to be voted out of position. And, you know, because of the past decisions that you've made, that in a city where 51% is black and 40% live below the poverty level and 43% earn less than $10,000 a year, and the students is their children. And when you spend money on building and on construction of the construction schools and spending the money, you don't seem to realize these factors about the people of this community. And like I said, very dissatisfied with the economy. And hope you take it to heart that the superintendent needs to resign and the rest of you need to vote out of office. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Robinson. I appreciate you sharing your thoughts this evening. That concludes public participation. I would entertain a motion to go into executive session to discuss personnel and pending litigation.
Excuse me, Mr. Robinson.
Yes, sir.
I was listening to your presentation, and I just wanted to check to make sure that what you said was correct. Now, who were you asking to resign?
Superintendent.
That's Brother Kasem?
Yes.
Okay, why do you say that? What do you base that on?
Based upon the fact that over the past condo, when they was going to build in the school, that he witnessed the decisions made by the board, that they didn't take no activity. He didn't do anything to prevent some of the decisions that was made, that we didn't get nothing out of the contracts or anything of that nature.
Now, when you say we, you mean the black contractor, or do you mean Valdosta in whole, as a whole?
The black contractors and Valdosta as part of it as well, because then nobody get nothing out of it.
Okay. All right, thank you very much.
Yes, sir, you're welcome.
All right, can you just say and spell your first and your last name for us and give us, I guess, your official title?
John Robinson. John Gary Robinson. I'm one of the head students. And I'm one representative of the community, the nonprofit organization that our president is going to support.
What does that nonprofit organization do? What's the mission?
It is a nonprofit organization.
Why did you decide to speak today? What was the message you wanted to do? Well,
the sick and tired of all the veterans, all the controversial, all the ways from practicing, cutting people, and then I seem to recognize the two factors of the actual problem that they need to be involved.
What is, you've mentioned some of the poverty level, some people need to resign, some people need to be voted out.
In this city, 40.5% of the people of the black population think it's about 51%. Come down to the population of the city. So, you know, being a school board, it's spending money, and you're not looking to the full activities of your parents when they're spending money, such as they're getting new schools and this kind of thing. They don't seem to realize these things that these contractors that come in the jobs make a better room for the family, all the parents and each other.
You mentioned the superintendent needs to resign. Some people need to be voted out.
Yeah.
Why?
Based on decisions that we've made in the past, bad decisions. Some of them governed by other members on the board. We need a lot of resources. We need to follow that influence. We need all the decisions and many of the people.
What are some of those bad decisions that you think they made?
Davis told us that the black contract was going to get problems with the funding for the new school that they did. And we didn't bring that. They were the one that said that black contract was going to get something out of the project to move the new thing out. And we went to get the board meetings, with them, with the company, back to the education, and when you look into the education that came to the dollar part, the cause of the community.
Are some of the decisions having to do, I know one of the agenda items obviously settling the lawsuit, is that one of the decisions you're talking about too, or is it just other things?
Other things in general, just overall in general. Yes, they just have a long history of making bad decisions.
What is your opinion on how they've been handling the Rush Probst hiring and where we're at with the investigation and then the Allen Rademacher lawsuit?
I think they're making a wise decision on that matter because the EOC didn't have any findings of certain merits. So that basically takes care of that.
I have a question for you.
Yes, sir.
I hear you give the statistics, and you seem to be pretty knowledgeable of them. What is your source of information?
The analysis of impediments taken in 2018 to 2024, due to the finding from J. Quad, the federal agent that did the disparity study here in Douglas.
Who is J. Quad?
J. Quad is the federal agent that do disparity impact studies for cities.
Okay. Thank you very much.